transcribed is transcribed.
Welcome to the world before infomercials, when TV stations either showed bad movies or shut down for the night. Channel 32, now Fox Chicago, dressed up schlocky monster movies from the 50s, like Invasion of the Saucer People, with something called Svengoolie.
The time has come for scary things, like monsters, ghosts, and vampire wings. Have a chicken. With horrible movies, but you can't get your money.
Actually, it was a DJ named Jerry G. Bishop dressed up as a hippie vampire. He told goofy jokes, threw rubber chickens, and turned bad movies into something worth watching. No one had VCRs back in Sven's heyday in the early 70s, so it lived on in the memories of those who were watching. Until now. The master tapes were found in the basement of the show's director, who recently died. Those tapes went to Rick Klein, the brains behind a website called fuzzymemories.tv. It's an online history of classic Chicago television.
So what we found were three episodes that basically have been lost since that time, from 1973.
I didn't understand anything.
The jokes were goofy, the fashions were oh so 70s, but Svengoolie is a part of Chicago culture. It's as much a part of our identity as Marshall Field's or the Bozo Show. It's one of those things that makes Chicago, Chicago.
We kind of want to hold on to and preserve these elements in the past, because otherwise then there's not going to be much difference between Chicago or Cleveland or Tampa.
Rob Hart, FM News.
The following prescribed is transcribed.
This was life before cable. If you were stuck at home watching TV on weekend nights, you could watch the monster movie show or go to bed. In the early 70s, the rubber dinosaurs and bad dubbing were made palatable by Svengoolie.
The time has come for scary things, like monsters, ghosts, and vampire wings. Have a steak. Like horrible movies.
A DJ named Jerry G. Bishop dressed up as a hippie vampire. He had guests like Tina McDowell, the penthouse pet of 1972.
It's a real treat for me to be here because, as you know, I like being seen in all the best places.
Yes, and you certainly have been, and I mean that sincerely. Speaking of have-been...
That was pretty raunchy stuff for local TV 40 years ago. Svengoolie was lost for decades until the master tapes were found in the home of the show's director, who recently passed away. Those tapes made their way to Rick Klein, the guy behind the website fuzzymemories.tv. It's an online museum of Chicago television.
They got away with a lot of things because it was on late at night, and somehow this passed through the censors.
If you watched it, hearing Svengoolie is like a doorway back to the past. At the time, for Channel 32, which ran the show, it was a way to make a little money off of some terrible movies.
Gave them the freedom to try some crazy things and see what the response is, and that's how the Svengoolie show evolved.
But Klein says it's one of those cultural items that makes Chicago, Chicago. Rob Hart, FM News.